Hey guys,
we're here on Throwback Thursday to do a Patronal request from this Patronal right here. Asked to check out some Paradise Lost Crucify. We haven't done Paradise Lost on the channel in a while. The last one was also a Throwback Thursday. By the way, they had a live album that was recorded during the pandemic. It was actually their live stream at the mill. Listening to that album, I realized that if I'm going to listen to a live recording from Paradise Lost, that's perhaps the best one. Because it feels live, but it also sounds like it's in the studio. It's kind of a hybrid.
Well, yeah, because it is live.
But there's nobody
there. There's no one there to make sounds.
Yeah, so it feels like it's in the studio. The funny thing about it is there's some songs on that performance that I like that version of the song more than the actual studio version. Because it still has that raw feel, like you're, you know, all together there. Yeah. You know what I mean? So really interesting record. I really enjoyed that at the mill. Anyways, Paradise Lost, Crucify. Are you ready for some PL?
Yeah.
All right, let's do it up. We'll be right back. before we talk about this, I just remind everybody that Mr. Holmes, I'm referring to him as Mr. Holmes, Mr. Holmes here, he's featured on a track of 1914 of their upcoming album, and that is a glorious duet, because it's really, it's a duet.
Yeah.
Guys, if you're fans of Paradise Lost, and you want to get a little bit of a taste of what 1914 is doing, go check out that song. Check out the video. We've done the video on the channel, so you can go check out our video. Please, it's absolutely magnificent. Now that I plugged 1914 on a Paradise Lost video, I'm sure they wouldn't mind. What do you got to say? This was amazing track. Such an amazing song.
You know, I would probably put this next to As I Die.
Is As I Die your favorite Paradise Lost song?
Well, when it comes to their older stuff, As I Die and True Belief are my favorite Paradise Lost song.
Wow.
When it comes to their older... I like Faith... I do like...
Faith Dividers.
And Death United. I do like this like a close third, right? But I do... I think this one maybe goes ahead of True Belief. So my
top, wow!
My top two are As I Die and this one.
That's interesting.
When it comes to the older
stuff.
Was
As I Die the first video we ever did?
No, True Belief was.
True Belief was the first video we ever did. All right. But As I Die, I think, was the second, no?
No. I don't think
so. Oh, no, we think we did Eternal.
We did Eternal the second time.
Yeah, we did
Eternal. As I Die, I think, was the third one.
The third one. And we did live ones. We didn't do... I don't think we did the studio ones.
As I Die was live, I think.
I think it was live.
The True Belief was studio, though.
And Eternal, I think, was studio as well.
I think Eternal was
studio. Well, the True Belief was a music video.
Yeah.
It was on a Throwback Thursday.
And same with the Faith Divides Death United.
Yeah. All right. So I'm just asking you that because I'm just like...
You know, I'm
just wanted to see where you are on your... Because the latest record, Obsidian, I mean, there's incredible tracks on
that. Incredible tracks.
That album is magnificent.
I can't look at that, like that version, that Paradise Lost, and like the older stuff we've done through Throwback Thursdays where I fell in love with the band. I can't look at them the same because the newer album... I fucking love, but the older Paradise Lost is where that's my jam.
Yeah, well, that's where you have your connection.
That's
where discovering the band.
Exactly, that's my connection is the older stuff. Don't get me wrong, newer stuff amazing. If I had to make a list, the newer songs would make it into my top 10. But this song and As I Die are my top.
It's funny you're saying this because I introduced you to Paradise Lost with the songs that I was introduced to Paradise Lost. I think the first ever PL song that I listened to was True Belief. I think that was the first record that I ever Icon was the first record that I ever... I had the CD. A friend of mine bought the CD and I borrowed and I listened to that album. So I think that was the first introduction to the band. Eternal, I think, was the second... before I listened to the whole album, I had listened to Eternal on a friend of mine had a mixtape with different bands or whatever. That's how I discovered King Diamond. King Diamond and Paradise Lost Eternal were on side A, Halloween. So I discover Halloween, I discover King Diamond, that was a great mixtape when you think about it. Celtic Frost was also on that mixtape. Those were the three bands that I remember specifically being on that mixtape. I don't remember any other band on that mixtape.
Four.
No, three. Celtic Frost, the
Halloween.
King Diamond, yeah.
So I think meant Halloween, like Halloween.
No, I don't think there was any Halloween track on that
mixtape. But that got a good taste.
Yeah, on those, but those three for some reason really stuck with me. You know, because I'm talking about the days when we would make like a tape of our favorite tracks and then we would take it to school. Hey, check this out. Like, because there's some gems here. I think you're going to like it, whatever. And we would pass mixtapes around. That's how we would discover a lot of bands. And then if you heard a song that you like, you would go and you'd buy the record that song belonged in, hoping that, oh, if I like that one song, I'm probably going to like the whole record. So that's kind of how it was. And then we didn't have a lot of money. So when you buy an album, you're kind of like committed to that album. So like it or not, you're listening to that album. I'm getting my, whatever, 10 bucks worth of this record. Like, I'm playing it until the cows come home. I don't care.
And then
I don't have money to buy
another
one.
Then you kind of copied it to the other tapes to help your friends, though.
Yeah, and then you would say, okay, because back in the day, you would look also at what the bands were wearing in music videos or wearing in the pictures that made the artwork of the scene. Like, there was a lot of things you would go by, and you would say, oh, you know, if they're wearing that band's shirt, it must be similar. Or, I mean, they have good taste, so let's check that band out. Or I would also use the labels. So if a band was released on Roadrunner, Metal Blade, at that time, Earache, Metal Blade, Roadrunner, Megaforce was another label at that time. It was almost guaranteed that if you picked up a CD that was released under one of those labels...
It would be good.
It would be good. Very few, like, it would be, like, duds. But it would, the percentage of duds was so minor compared to the ones that you would discover randomly just by picking up an album because it was released by that label. That was one of the criteria that I would take. I mean, because we didn't have internet. We didn't have ways of...
The simpler times.
Yeah. And it was like you. When you discover a new band, because let's say your friend came over with, let's say, Paradise Lost CD and he put it on your CD player, you're in love with it, then you wouldn't listen to anything else for like months. You would just listen to Paradise Lost, everything. It's just like you do now. When you discover a band that you like and you find a song, you just listen to that band ad nauseum.
Yeah, but not just that song. I make sure
to... No, you listen to everything. But yeah. It's just like, we used to do that too. Now there's just so much variety.
I never get sick of it.
Now there's just so much... I get sick of listening to you listening to the same band all the time. Like, fuck. Sometimes it gets annoying. Anyways, Paradise Lost, Crucify. This track is phenomenal. I gotta say this. I don't know if you capture this, but this song has that guitar DNA sound of Paradise Lost. And they do this thing that I really enjoy very frequently, which is they have one guitar standing here doing like a riff slash solo, like a nice little architected lick, let's put it that way. And then the rest of the sound is moving. So the other guitar, the drum, bass, vocals, everything is on the escalator moving.
That was happening during the chorus. There was that little lick that kept happening in the chorus, and it kept going, but everything else was moving, like...
Moving forward. But there's one piece. There's one guitar that stands still, and everything else is still moving. And you saw that towards the last third of the track became really noticeable.
Yeah.
Because the song is dying out, is moving all towards the twilight of its existence, and that guitar is just still, like, jamming and grooving, and everything else is moving past it. And that piece doesn't move. I find that that's a very particular Paradise Lost DNA, specifically when you go back more into their throwback years where they would do that. And I love that because your ears, when you're listening to the song on with good headphones, I think if you're just listening in a sound system, sometimes it kind of gets lost because, it's not as filtered, as the quality is different, right? But when you're listening to it on headphones, one of them has that guitar standing still. And the rest of the sound is kind of moving from one ear to the other. So there's a sense of movement across your brain while one piece is still there. So your ears, one is tagged in to the piece that's not moving and the other one is kind of going on the journey. It's so cool. And it's so like melancholic in how it moves. Fuck. These guys. One of my favorite bands.
Yeah.
One of my favorite bands. I got to see them before the pandemic. They played in Toronto. The same year, 2018. Yeah, the same year that Wintersun came to town.
It was the day before.
The day before. Wintersun was here. I think they played on, if I'm remembering correctly. They played
on Thanksgiving.
They played on Thanksgiving Sunday. On Thanksgiving Sunday, I spent my Thanksgiving at the Paradise Lost show with Soulsphere. What a fucking great lineup that was. Anyways, I went to see them on, the crowd was... It wasn't a big crowd, I guess, because it was Thanksgiving. Yeah. It was not a good night for Paradise Lost in terms of playing on Thanksgiving. I could care less. Fuck it. I was like, I'm not going to miss it. Because it had been like 20 years, 15 years since they had toured in North America. So I went to the show, great night, and then Wintersun played on Tuesday. And at that time, Valterio was already their drummer. And I remember the guys from Paradise Lost saying, hey, you know the drummer from Paradise Lost? He's a Finnish guy. He's one of ours. He's amazing, eh? Like, I remember them telling me, I was like, I didn't know he was Finnish. I should have been able to tell because his quality was definitely above the rim.
Yeah.
Above the rim. He had that Finnish vampire blood in him playing the drums. All right, guys.
Vampire.
Yeah, because Finnish people don't get old. Have you ever seen an old Finnish person? Look at Tarja now. She looks the same as she looked like fucking 30 years ago. The woman hasn't aged a bit.
That's true.
Marco's always looked old, so technically he hasn't gotten old. Because he's always been old. So, as far as I know, all vampires are Finnish people. Or all Finnish people are vampires. Either one or the other. Whatever you want to call it. All right, guys. On that note, thank you for watching this Throwback Thursday. Come back tomorrow. We'll have more videos for you. See you guys.
See ya.